time for a secret operation. What is the point of a tap in the ocean?
Oh. That's not a real picture.
It isn't a real picture, because in Britain you'd have two taps for no reason at all.
Okay, I don't understand this. So you have a hot tap and you have a cold tap,
yes.
Right? Yes. Well, how's that? So you're trying to wash your hands, yes. And what happens? You put it under the hot tap, you're like, oh! And then you have the cold tap, oh! Haven't discovered there's a mixer tap. What is it called?
We get.
Is that, did you find that baffling when you arrived?
I still find it baffling. Yeah, and no. I don't understand radiators. Why you want to heat an entire house with a small hot metal plate in the corner? It doesn't work.
What would you do instead?
We have forced air in Canada, otherwise you freeze to death.
What do you have a for? What?
Forced air, just you know, aircon.
Forced air, aircon.
Yes. Yeah.
I've never heard the term. I'm 40, late 40s, and I don't. I genuinely didn't know how old I was. I'm not going to bother sitting here working out, but I'm 50 soon, and I've never heard the term forced air. Well, not in that context.
I love the fact... I love the fact, Rhod, that I'm asking you some quite complicated science questions and you don't know how old you are.
I'm about 49.
You're about 49. Have you just worked it out?
Yeah. I'm so used to saying I'm 50 in a few years. I'm so used to saying that I, for a moment, it's
the thing is, though, it is quite good to know how old you are. And the producer has just told me in my ear, Rhod, that you're 48.
Is there a really easy way to remember how old you are?
Yeah.
Is there, like, a little... No. That's some kind of song I can sing or something? Or...
I've never needed a mnemonic for my age. I'm sure I could invent one. I'm going to come back to what's the point?
What's the point?
What's the point? That's the question.
I've written one for you.
Yeah,
I've written one for you.
Okay, here we go.
How about, like, what year are we in today? When am I born? Just take that away. You don't have to be a whiz. That's how old Rhod Gilbert is.
Followed your poetic guidelines, I'm 48.
At the risk of repetition, is the point of a tap in the ocean?
Is it so that when sea levels rise, you can turn it off? I don't know.
So it's not actually a water tap.
It's not a tap. Rather a tap
so what else could you tap? What's another kind of tapping that people do when they're trying to listen
in?
There's
a shark behind you.
Yeah.
Is it a wire when they put a wire, transatlantic radio communication wire?
It's Cold War. It's called Operation Ivy Bells, and it took place from 1971 to 1981, and it was the USA wiretapping a Russian underseas cable. That thing, they're moving it into position there, is a giant tape recorder, and
they just
put it onto the wire. So the sailors on a submarine, the USS Halibut, located a Soviet cable...
Halibut!
They located a Russian cable off the Russian East Coast, and they moved a six-metre-long recording pod around it to track the communications. The thing I really like about it, because this we're talking some years ago now, the device had to be updated every month, and so divers had to leave a submarine once a month and change the tapes. But it was hugely successful. It ran for a decade until a National Security Agency employee of the United States sold the information to the KGB.
Spying was a lot more hassle back then when you got to train a team of divers, get submarines. Yeah. Now you just need somebody's maiden name and their first pet's name and you're off.
Yeah.
If you're Russians, you just have to go and see Donald Trump and ask him.